Hi, my dear Mercedesers. In this video, we are going to be talking something more about the airflow meter. So let's do it right now. In this video, I'm going to be talking something more about the airflow meter. I would like to explain you how everything functions and what is what, for those that want to know something more about the airflow sensor. Here, you know that this is called the sensor plate. You have this thing here, you have this thing here. As for this one, if we flip this unit over, we can see that this thing is connecting this part to this part, and the spring that preloads the lever here. Now, as for the second one, for this one here, if out of who knows which reason you get detonations, and those can either break your sensor plate or make it skew, well, this sensor plate can go here up as it rests here, about where my screwdriver is, approximately, let's say it like that. Then you're going to get vacuum leaks, and you have an issue. As soon as it happens, then you will have to take a screwdriver like this one, as I have, to put it like this, and then you will have to take a hammer and to nail it downwards. As you do that, you're going to move this sensor plate downwards, but you must be very careful and very gentle, because it is going to fall like this. As it does, you must be, I repeat, very careful, because it can fall too much. And then here, you can get here again, vacuum leaks, too much air. Then you will have to undo all these, this one, this one, this one, all of them, you see, to take off this rubber boot, and then you will have to do the reversed thing of what you have done, to hammer it here, so that you can then get this sensor plate up, resting something like this. I had some questions, for example, here. If you look carefully, you can see a gap here, where my finger is now. There were some of you that asked me if that is normal. Yes, it is. As for the second thing, I would like you to look at the sensor plate now. And some of you asked me also If this is normal for the sensor plate to rest like this, a bit downwards and not flat. Yes, the answer is that it is absolutely normal for the sensor plate to rest like this. And that's pretty much it. This is the plate, I've been showing that. And now, the next thing is this lever here. If you undo this screw, then here you're going to see a bar. There is a bar here that connects this part with this one. This bar holds this lever. And now, as for that infamous CO screw, if you know for sure that this CO screw has never been touched and that no one has been messing around with it, then don't touch it. And I repeat, don't touch it. Don't let someone else touch this CO screw. What is happening? If you look like this, as I have told you, you have a bar here. This bar holds this lever, which on this sensor plate rests. And now you have a lever inside a lever. And that's this lever. So as you take your 3 mAh, as you put it like this, and now as you turn it, you must push it in, and now as it becomes stiff, now you can turn it either clockwise or counterclockwise. What happens actually? The more you screw this CO screw in, the more this second lever goes upwards. And now, as it does, the more it goes upwards, it touches the plunger of the fuel distributor. As it does, the sensor plate is going to become stiffer. And if you do it for too much, if you screw clockwise for too much, this inside lever is going to touch it more and to press it more than it should, and the plunger is going to open the way to the fuel from the lower to the upper chamber and to the injectors, and you're going to get more fuel than air, and you will have issue. This issue will be hard starts. The more you do it counterclockwise with this 3 mils Allen, the more you do it like this, the more is this lever going to fall down. So it's practically not going to be touching the plunger. And this sensor plate is going to become extremely loose. As it does, something like this, I suppose. Not like this exactly, but let's say it like this. And then the more air you're going to deliver in and to a little fuel. And then the engine won't start, or it's going to start and you're going to get a lean mixture. So that's it. If you remember that I've been talking that the plunger here, this one, this guy, and the sensor plate make a counterbalance like this. The last thing, but not least, is this. I took my potentiometer off, and if you break these two contacts, well, you will have to get this whole unit. So here we have practically the lever. The rod, these two levers, and this part here with the contacts for the potentiometer. The purpose of this video was to tell you if there is a quirk here on this CO screw, don't touch it. If you know for sure that no one has been messing around with this screw, don't do that. The screw can never, and I repeat, never readjust from itself. So it can never happen that either this CO screw makes this plate to be too loose or too stiff. Once set, it never has to be readjusted again. Remember, and don't let the mechanics do anything here, do any adjustments. If you do them, you will have to do them with multimeters. If you experience any shakings of your engine, then check your injectors at first. If the injectors are good, then check if all the chambers deliver the exact and the same amount of fuel. Check everything, check those things. Many people don't know anything about this, what I'm talking about. If you do any adjustments here, then you're going to be doing very precise readjustments to get the system back as it was. And I'm talking about really, really precise adjustments. For this much. Here, for this much. Let me get it back. And then you will have to wait for about 10 seconds. And then you press the accelerator lever. And all over again, watching your multimeters. So my dear ones, if you enjoyed this video, then please don't click the button skip at. It is going to help me a lot. And till the next video, happy Mercedesing!